daughters of God.
Yes, yes, yes.
Do you believe that?
Yeah.
Do you believe you're a new creature? Hallelujah. Do you believe that old things are passed away and behold, all things come new? Because God is trying to get to a point. Do you believe he really died on the cross? Come on, people of God. Do you really believe that? Because that's what it's all about. Not just dying on the cross, but do you believe he rose on the third day? Because it's all about the resurrection power of God. Because no other God has done that. Buddha is still in the ground.
Oh, yes, he is.
That's right.
Muhammad, too.
Yeah.
But what else does he have to do to get you to believe? Do he have to swallow you up in a fish? Do he have to take you to the depth? Do he have to get you to get your son and take him to the mountain and try to kill him? What do he have to do to get your attention? To get you to come.
Come on.
To the King's table. Come on.
Amen.
To the King's table.
Yes, come on.
Let us all sit at the King's table. Where they serve up restoration at the King's table. Where they serve up forgiveness at the King's table.
Hallelujah.
Where love is passed around in a bowl at the King's table.
Yes.
Now come on up to the King's table. Have some mashed love. Hallelujah.
Yes.
It's passed around at the table. Hallelujah. The bread of life is at the King's table. Hallelujah.
Yes.
If you want some bread, how about some water? Hallelujah. Well, you'll never thirst again.
Hallelujah.
It's served. At the King's table.
Yes,
it is.
Hallelujah.
Oh, 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 oh. Y'all get that on Monday. They say on Monday. You'll get that on Monday. Luke 22, verses 29 through 30 said, I have appointed unto you a kingdom, as my Father has appointed unto me, that ye may eat and drink at the table in my kingdom.
Yeah.
And sit on the throne, judges the 12 tribes of ye in Israel.
Yes, yes, yes.
Let me just break it down for you. The message says, who would you rather be? The one who eats the dinner or the one who serves the dinner?
Amen.
You rather eat or be served?
Yes.
But I've taken my place among you as one who serves.
Yes.
And you stuck with me through thick and thin. Now I concur on you the royal authority my Father concurred unto me. So you can eat and drink at my table in my kingdom and be strengthened as you taking up responsibility among the congregation of God's people.
Yes.
Yeah, that's good.
When you sit down, the food is already there for you. You don't have to wait for nothing for when served. He said, for now there is no condemnation. So you don't even have to convince yourself to come to the King's table. When God gets through with you, you're ready to sit down at the table and eat real good.
Real good.
I ain't talking about your physical eating. I'm talking about your spiritual, which is going to carry you through life, because you were spiritual before you were. If you were created in his image, then you were first
spiritual.
Thank you.
Amen.
If you don't begin to feed the spiritual man at the King's table, hallelujah, he's not going to be one of those bowls that come and say, slap and say, look, I need to be fed.
Right.
But he's such a gentleman that he'll sit back and wait. Till you hunger and thirst after righteousness. And the word said, you shall be filled. Wake up, America. Hallelujah. Wake up, people of God. We can't continue, because God forbid that we should continue in sin.
Hallelujah.
Now is the time. Hallelujah.
Right.
This is the hour. This is the dispensation. Hallelujah. That we begin to do what God has called us to do. Join hands together. Lock arms together. Hallelujah. Unite together in the unity of faith. Hallelujah.
Yes.
And let's begin to tear down some walls.
Glory to God.
I got these people that ready to tear down some walls.